Okay, this is a Migo from Mansions of Madness. I found the model to be pretty boring, but we'll see what we can do about this one. I'm not sure about a paint scheme either, but I think something overall pinkish, kind of palish pink, something. We'll just see what happens. I'm gonna start with some bone colors here. I think for the wings, I'm gonna do pallid bone for the fleshy parts. And now I'm gonna do pretty much an entire coat of bony matter, pretty much all over him, just to get something of a, like a tinting base coat or something to work off of. With that in place, I'm gonna start working some pink into this. I think for the tail part and like the lower part of his body, I'm gonna introduce some pink on top. Try to keep it mostly focused to the underside and remove some of the excess from the top. This isn't gonna be a strong pink, just, you know, tinting it a bit to get some weird fleshy crab-like color. I really don't know what to call this part, but for the like skeletal parts or the fingery parts, that frame, the fleshy parts of the wings, I'm gonna go for some aged hide. And I'm gonna use the same color, aged hide, for these. I don't know what this is, like sprouts, mouthy nasal sprouts. Let's paint that head with some peachy flesh. Maybe some weird malignant green is gonna look interesting in his eyes. And for that juicy brain, we're gonna introduce some slaughter red and remove the excess from the highlights. Let's paint some grim black over that poor guy's hair. And he does deserve some disturbing eyes using ivory. I'm not overly happy with this guy right now, but let's try some ivory dry brushing to accentuate some of the details here. Pretty much overall, the wings, the body, everything. Let's see what happens. I find those eyes pretty boring, so let's use some of that grim black and just deepen them, darken them a lot. So far, this guy is turning out pretty bland. All of these colors are very uninspiring. So I'm gonna try to add some, a little bit more contrast to the guy by using some runic gray for the scaly parts to darken them down a little. I got inspired by some artwork, which I think had this sprouty stuff in a more green tint. So let's add some forest bright. See what happens. I'm not sure this really fits the paint scheme, but hey, let's try it anyway. And he is done. Like I said, I'm not really happy with how he came out. I think the model is pretty boring. And this, I think I could have picked a better, more interesting paint scheme. But this will have to do. There's another Mego that I'm gonna paint later. Let's do something more fun then. Thank you. See you next time. Bye.